A very good morning. Today we are going to start the unit 4. The covered topics are compensation and the definition and the concepts. The objectives and the dimensions of compensation program. Factors influencing the compensation. Role of compensation and what in modern organizations, compensation as a retention strategy, aligning compensation strategy with business strategy, managing compensation, designing a compensation system, internal and external equity, pay determinants, framework of compensation policy, influence of pay on employee attitude and behavior, the new trends in compensation management at national and international level. So these are the covered topics in unit 4. Now we start with the definition of compensation management. The term compensation is used to indicate the employee's gross earnings in the form of financial reward and the benefits. So in simple words, whatever the output given by the employee is treated as the employee's earning, and we will give in the financial reward and benefits. It means that in general, the compensation is in the form of the financial matter. The compensation is the monetary benefit which is given to an employee or worker given their services to an organization. It includes the components like the salary, wages, bonuses, etc. The compensation provided helps in motivating the employees, build their careers, and ensure that they are committed in achieving the company goals. So definitely the compensation helps the employees to motivate towards the organization goals. Not only the organizational goals, it is useful for building the career and it improves the commitment among the people, employees in the organization towards achieving the company goals. The financial component or compensation includes salary, bonuses, and all the benefits like fringe benefits, incentives, and non-financial compensation includes awards, rewards, citation, prize, recognition, which can motivate the employees towards highest productivity. As we know very well, the motivation is the key component of employee behavior. For getting highest productivity from your employee, it is a matter of giving financial and non-financial benefits. Where here, the non-financial benefits today, encouraging the more of employees towards highest productivity. Because all the companies, they are providing the financial compensation. So they cannot be motivated with financial. Apart from the financial compensation, we need to offer the non-financial compensation benefits so that we definitely get the highest productivity from your employees. Because work is equal to value, the compensation is equal to productivity. That is a simple formula for the compensation management. So these are the different others. We give the definitions of a compensation. Compensation is paying people for work. Paying people for work. The given by the Dale order. The compensation is what employees receive in exchange for their contribution to the organization. The kit Davis. And according to Cashio, the compensation includes direct cash payments, indirect payments in the form of employee benefits, and incentives to motivate employees to strive for a higher level of productivity. In simple terms, as the Dal Yoder, it is for work, paying for the people work. As Keith Davis, exchange for their contribution to the organization. The same what they exchange, the work they exchange, but they are using different terms. And the Cashio directs that compensation includes direct cash payments, indirect payments. So every employee, they are expecting the benefits and the motivation from the employer by offering incentives. So obviously they can give the higher level of productivity. So here, the compensation objective is higher levels of productivity. Now we enter into objectives of compensation. What are the objectives? First one is, the compensation should be paid to each employee on the basis of their abilities and the training. So here, we give priority for the abilities of employees. Because if the employee is able to complete a work or a complete a task, so that we can give a good compensation. Today, the companies expects the abled employees, skill-based employees are required for today's companies. Due to the pandemic situation of today, the companies are trying to know the abilities of their employee because they want to reduce the employability and improve the productivity level. That is only possible with to know and evaluate the abilities of employees and the training which is given by you. These two are the factors which decide the compensation package to you. Right. Second one is compensation should be in the form of package. Why package? Because the basic is equal to all the level of employees. For example, if you take the same grade or else the same level of employees in your organization, all are getting the same salary. In the means, the basic. Whereas we can show the difference in the compensation because compensation includes the salary plus incentive plus bonus plus other facilities or other any benefits. That is the reason when an employee is placed, before that they will check the compensation package. They negotiate for the compensation in the case of experienced persons. It is not possible with the freshers, but if you are well experienced and well skilled, you have already done different projects, so that you will be welcome to my company and then I will offer a good compensation package. Due to other factors like the sincerity of my employees, the experience of my employees, I have to check. So I will offer the same basic salary, but I will give you other benefits. I will give you the other benefits. These benefits are a part in your package. It's called compensation package. It should motivate the employees towards increasing productivity. Definitely, the compensation package motivate your employees because every employee, they work not only for the organizational objective. At the same time, they check for the compensation. How his exchange, his work, or his productivity with the organization? What is the measurement? How can be benefited? So these are all the motivational drives. Because without a motivational drive, you cannot work properly. You cannot offer a good or highest productivity. It requires motivation. That is only possible with the compensation. That is the reason today, the IT professionals, they are switching from one company to another company because of getting more compensation package, highest compensation package. If a company offers a good compensation package, definitely they switch to the company. They don't have any other things. They have only one object to that, to get a good compensation package. Here the compensation package shows the worth of the employee. The worth of the employee. If you are getting 2 lakhs per month, your package is 25 lakhs per annum. It shows that you are more skilled. But if you take a manufacturing company, they cannot offer that kind of compensation package. We have very slight difference because the basic is same, everything is same. You have a difference in incentives. It may be affected only 10% of your basic salary. So based on the industry type, the compensation packages and the compensation system may be different, but definitely it will be a motivational factor. The next objective is it should be capable of taking care of employees for safety and security needs also. As per the Abraham Maslow's, we know the safety and security needs. Every employee, they are expecting their job security. They feel that, or they need to feel that they are safe. Their family is safe. Socially, they are safe. Physically, they are safe. It is only possible by offering a good compensation package. And you have to create an environment that you are taking care of your employees. You have to check whether you are in the same line or not. Next objective is it should be flexible and clear. So you don't worry about your compensation package. And make sure that your compensation system, compensation packages should be very flexible. Because the company and its profits, the nature of your product, the demand of your product, the competition, the governments and other legal formats, the unions. We have different types of external bodies which influences your business and its operations. That is the reason we should be very flexible and clear. And you don't be excessive. You should not be excessive. And the compensation should be decided by the management, because they have their own norms by the law, fixed by the legislations in consultation with the unions. That is the reason it should be decided only by the management. Dimensions of compensation. What are the dimensions? Oh, you have 4 dimensions. The wage and salary, the incentives, fringe benefits, perquisites. Oh, one by one we will check. The first one is wage and salary. So before going to the wage and salary, we need to know what is wage and salary. So wage is given for the day to day or else every week they will give you. Then that exchange is called the wage. Whereas the salary is a fixed for a month. You cannot calculate every day. It is fixed even though it is 29 days, 30 days or 31 days. We treat it as 1 month. The salary is for 1 month is fixed. You will get the same salary up to 1 year. It's called a wage and a salary. So in simple words, wages refers to as remuneration to the workers, particularly hourly rated payment. But whereas the salary refers to a remuneration paid to white collar employees, including managerial personnel. So wages and salaries are paid on the basis of fixed period of time and normally not associated with productivity of an employee at a particular time. The second one is the incentive. It is an additional payment given to your employee. Why we give incentive? Because if you want to increase the productivity level of your employee, you have linked these incentives with the productivity. So higher production or cost saving, sometimes both. These incentives may be given on individual basis or sometimes on group basis. Third one is fringe benefits. It includes the benefits which are provided the employees either having long-term impact, like we will give the PF Provident Fund, the gratuity pension, or an occurrence of certain events like medical benefits, accident relief, health and life insurance, are facilitating in performance of job like uniforms, canteens, recreation, etc. Perquisites. The fourth one is perquisites. These are normally provided to managerial person either to facilitate the job performance or to retain them. So for retaining your employees, we use this dimension as a perquisites, and such perquisites include company car, the club membership, free residential accommodation, paid holiday trip to the family, we will give the stock options, etc. So these are all the dimensions of compensation. So once I repeat, unit 4, we have these concepts. Concept of compensation, the definitions. According to Dahl Yoder, the compensation is paying people for work. And according to Keith Davis, compensation is what employees receive in exchange for their contribution to the organization. And third one is cashio. Compensation includes direct cash payment, direct payment in the form of employee benefits and incentives to motivate employees to strive for highest